Here we'll take a look at some examples of determining exact trig function values when the angle is given in radians, and this time we'll use reference triangles. So let's start by sketching negative 8 pi over 3 radians in standard position, and then we'll determine our reference angle and then our reference triangle. So because our angle is negative, we're going to be rotating clockwise. So here's our initial side. And one complete revolution clockwise would be negative 2 pi radians to here. So if we have negative 8 pi over 3 radians, and we just rotated clockwise 2 pi radians, that's the same as negative 6 pi over 3. Notice this simplifies to negative 2 pi radians, plus we need to rotate another negative 2 pi over 3 radians to end up at negative 8 pi over 3 radians. So a half of a revolution would be negative pi radians, so negative 2/3 pi radians would be somewhere in here. So our terminal side would be here. So if this is negative 2 pi over 3 radians, that would leave 1 pi over 3 radians more to the negative x-axis. So our reference angle is going to be pi over 3 radians. So if we construct our reference triangle, it would look something like this. Well, pi over 3 radians is the same as 60 degrees. So the relationship among the three sides would be 1, 2, square root 3, but of course both the x and the y coordinates would be negative. So now we can use this reference triangle to determine all of these trig function values. Now of course we could have converted this to degrees from the beginning, but I think it's important to get practice using and recognizing degrees in radians. So cosine theta would be the ratio of the adjacent side to the hypotenuse. That's going to be negative 1/2. Secant theta is going to be the reciprocal of cosine theta. That's going to be negative 2 over 1, or just negative 2. Sine theta would be the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse. That's going to be negative square root 3 over 2. Cosecant theta is going to be the reciprocal of sine theta. So that's going to be negative 2 over square root 3. Let's go ahead and rationalize the denominator. So we're going to have negative 2 square roots of 3 over 3. Tangent theta would be the ratio of the opposite side to the adjacent side. So that's going to be negative square root 3 over negative 1, which simplifies to positive square root 3. And cotangent theta would be the reciprocal of tangent theta. So we're going to have negative 1 over negative square root 3, which will simplify to a positive fraction. And now we'll rationalize the denominator. So we have positive square root 3 all over 3.